Occasionally, when you have a pivot table like this, you may want to extract certain of the numbers in order to use in other calculations within your spreadsheet. And what you may have noticed is if you click, for example, on that cell there, you type equals, and let's say we want to extract day 7, the Sunday. When I click on the pivot table, you may see something like this where a formula is developed even though you weren't trying to develop one. We need to explain this and just explain how it can be switched off, but why it can also be useful. What you'll see is when I click enter, it has gone and pulled out that number, but using this formula. We need to understand what this formula is doing. So we can just activate the function wizard and just understand what it's doing. You can try and work through this function on your own via the function wizard, but I find it's easier to actually click on a relevant cell and then look at what it's doing. So what you'll see, the first thing it says is data field. It's the name of the data field to extract your data from, and you'll see it says bill. Because we clicked on this cell here, it recognizes that the data it's looking at is the sum of bill, so it knows that it's the bill field. Notice the inverted commas, so if you wanted to create this yourself, you need to put the inverted commas. The next item is the pivot table. So you'll see is the reference to a cell or range of cells in the pivot table. It needs to know where the pivot table starts, and you'll see Excel has automatically gone to cell A4 and said that cell is linked to a pivot table. The reason it does that cell is because as you move the pivot table around or you change items, it may get bigger or smaller, but we do know that that cell will always exist. The next item is something called field 1. And you'll see this is the field to refer to. And if you read it, it says field 1, day of week. So it knows that it's looking for the bill and it must go to the day of week. We know that that's the day of week. And what must it do with the day of week? Well, here in item it says it must extract the number 7 from it. And as you see, if you click on it, another field appears. So we can keep doing this. But for now, let's say OK. So you'll see it's come here and extracted the 138.96. We can actually rework this. So let's go into the formula and change that to a 6, for example, because now I want to pull through Saturday. Let's see if it gets it right. 128.73. There's 128.73. With this knowledge now, we can actually build a little bit of intelligence into this formula. So for example, over here I'm going to put day of week. And for now I'll just put the number 6 in there. I can then go to my GetPivotData, and instead of referring to hard-coded numbers, I'm going to go and change that number 6 to say rather look at whatever's in that cell there. When I say OK, you'll see it's pulling through that number there. If I go here and change this to, for example, a 1, the GetPivotData immediately knows it's looking elsewhere, and it looks up here, the 435. The benefit of the GetPivotData as well is that no matter what happens here, this will always be correct. So if someone comes here and maybe sorts this, moves the 1 down to there, doesn't matter. What it's doing is going, looking through the various bits of information, looking for the day of the week, that is a 1, and pulling through the relevant information. Let's now make a slightly more complex pivot table. So we'll just delete that. And let's take the destination network and maybe put it in the column labels. So what we now have is the day of the weeks, destination network, and a whole bunch of numbers. For now, I'm going to go and say, please give me, I'm going to say equals, I can choose anyone, let's choose that cell there. Notice that the formula is a little bit bigger. I'm just going to push enter for now, and let's just look what the formula is doing. Again, the first thing, get the data field bill, so it's pulling the information from here. Where's the pivot table? It's saying the pivot table is attached to the cell in A4. First thing, destination network, Vodacom. So it knows that it must look in the destination network and look until it finds Vodacom. The next field is given, day of the week. You'll see the item is 5. So it now knows it needs to find Vodacom and then find the 5 and bring through that particular number. Let's now build a bit of intelligence in. Let's put the network here. We'll type Vodacom, day of week here, and let's put the 5. We can now go back into our GetPivotData function and replace the word Vodacom with a cell reference. And similarly, replace the item 5, sorry, the item 2, with a cell reference. I say OK. Nothing much has changed, but now I can, as long as I get the spelling correct, change this to, let's make it MTN, click Enter. You'll see the number has changed to 32, and if we look, the 32 ties in with that day of the week. Let's change that to day 1, for example, and you'll see it goes to 108, which is that number there. So you can use the GetPivotData to extract information straight out of a pivot table. You can try and work straight from the function wizard, but my suggestion is rather click on a cell equals to one of the cells you want, and then work through the syntax in the function wizard to make it do what you want to do. Now occasionally you don't actually want the GetPivotTable. Let's say that you know that your pivot table is never going to change, it looks exactly like this, and you want to pull through this grand total. But no matter what you do, if you say equals and you touch the pivot table, immediately you've got a GetPivotData. So there's two ways around this. The first way is you can't click on the pivot. So I can see that this cell is in cell G13. So I can now go equals G13. When I say enter, I'll get that number and it'll always refer there. So that's where it's looking. The risk, of course, with this, if for example I change this and remove the 2 and I say OK, well, it's no longer there, it still looks at that cell and that's incorrect. So that's one way of doing it. But if you permanently want to do it, every time you want to be able to equals and click on the pivot but not get the GetPivotData, you can change your options. The way you do that, click somewhere in the pivot table, go to the pivot table tools, and you'll see under options there's something called generate GetPivotData, and it's ticked. If I untick it, so you'll see now it is unticked, I can now go to my pivot table. When I say equals that cell, you'll see the formula is just a normal reference. If you need to switch it back on, pivot table tools, go to the options, generate GetPivotData, and you'll see it's back.